Hey guys, welcome to the first installment of the series of basic crypto concepts for beginners. If you are wanting to get into crypto but don't really know anything about the space or how any of it works or what it all means yet, then you're in the right place. In this first installment, I'm going to give a basic overview of crypto, and in the following videos, I'll dig a little bit deeper into some of the more specific concepts. So take this first video as a beginner's overview to the question, what is cryptocurrency? But wait, before we start, if you find this video helpful or interesting, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Not only that, but we'll be picking our three favorite comments to send a $10 trading bonus to. So try to comment something interesting or funny in the comments below. And we'll pick the winners, send you that trading bonus. All right, let's jump in. Cryptocurrency, known as crypto for short, is a form of virtual currency that allows for secure transactions through cryptography. Unlike fiat currencies such as the US dollar or euro, there's no centralized authority that backs or influences the value of cryptocurrency. Most crypto is maintained through the blockchain, which acts as a public ledger distributed across a large number of computers that records transactions, controls the creation of new coins, and verifies ownership. Cryptocurrencies are designed to streamline the modern financial system by offering a means of exchange that makes it possible for parties to transact independently of institutions, such as banks and clearinghouses. So, cryptocurrencies are a new paradigm through which we can view money. Crypto has a wide range of applications, from gaming and non-fungible tokens, NFTs, to complex financial instruments such as decentralized finance, or DeFi. The value of a cryptocurrency is not determined by any government or central party, but rather by the laws of supply and demand. To hold a cryptocurrency or make a transaction, you'll need a compatible wallet, which is a type of software or device that stores the public and private keys needed to interact with the blockchain. It should be noted that the wallet itself does not actually hold any crypto, but rather provides an address to your funds on the blockchain. That's something we can dig into more later. Making a cryptocurrency transaction is essentially authorizing the movement of a certain amount of cryptocurrency from one wallet address to another wallet address. This process is typically verified by a third party known as miners, who access your public key to confirm that your private key was used to initiate the transaction. Once the block that includes your transfer is confirmed, the ledger is updated with the new balance of both your address and the address of the recipient. As of early 2022, there were over 13,000 different cryptocurrencies on the market, with more being created each day. Bitcoin, invented by the pseudonymous Satoshi Nakamoto in 2008, was the world's first cryptocurrency, and it remains the most popular to this day. While each cryptocurrency was designed for a specific purpose, they can be broadly categorized into two types. Keep in mind, not all cryptos fit perfectly into these two categories. And there are many subcategories when you dig a little deeper. Firstly, coins such as Bitcoin operate as a means of exchange. In Bitcoin's case, the value is derived from a deflationary mechanism that ensures that fewer coins are created as time goes on, and an inbuilt hard cap on the amount that can be created overall. This mechanism has led to some analysts drawing a comparison between Bitcoin and gold. Other examples of proof-of-work coins with the primary aim of being a means of exchange include Litecoin and Chia. Next is utility tokens, which have a wide variety of applications, from a method of authentication to a type of credit that can be used to exchange for services on an app or platform. Examples of utility tokens include Ethereum, which can be used to access a huge ecosystem of applications and dApps, and Filecoin, which grants users access to a decentralized file transfer and storage network. The value of a utility token is derived from the value of the underlying service provided. As prices in the crypto market are typically far more volatile than the stock market, the list of top cryptocurrencies is constantly changing. The mainstays include Bitcoin, which always retains its position as the largest cryptocurrency in the market. Consistently trailing right behind is Ethereum, which powers many of the innovative crypto applications we see today. As Ethereum is used to pay for services and power other apps, it often ranks higher than Bitcoin in terms of trading volume. The crypto industry represents a diverse range of opportunities for retail and institutional investors alike. While speculation undoubtedly drives the majority of crypto investment, many crypto holders believe in its potential as a fiat alternative, or enjoy the other innovations within crypto, such as DeFi, which has gained traction as a popular alternative to traditional wealth management.
The NFT boom has attracted interest from both art collectors and auction houses, such as Sotheby's and Christie's. On March 12, 2021, Beeple's Everydays, the first 5,000 days, was sold for an eye-catching 38,525 ETH, which was $69 million at the time, through an online auction held by Christie's. Another innovation from NFTs has been the advent of GameFi and play-to-earn models, built on the idea that users should be able to derive financial value from items earned through gameplay. According to Bloomberg, over $40 billion in NFT trades were executed in 2021. Driven by declining returns in cash reimbursements and the weakening dollar, firms such as MicroStrategy have started to invest into crypto assets as a hedge against inflation. This practice has also become popular in countries undergoing economic crises, where many investors consider the risk of market volatility to be lower than that of hyperinflation. Many crypto enthusiasts believe that blockchain technology has the potential to create a fairer, more interactive, and more equitable version of the internet, known as Web3. The idea is to cut out the middlemen that control many aspects of the traditional internet, such as authentication services and server hosting. By decentralizing the internet through smart contracts and other Web3 technologies, developers and users can work together to create a better, higher trust, and more interconnected services. Cryptocurrencies are most commonly bought and sold through crypto exchanges. Phemex, for example, is an efficient crypto trading and investment platform that allows users to buy, trade, and invest in hundreds of different cryptocurrencies. Phemex also acts as a secure wallet that traders can use to store many popular cryptos. The eye-catching long-term returns created by the meteoric rise of Bitcoin have attracted a lot of interest into the crypto industry. As with traditional securities such as stocks, it's critical that each investor exercise an adequate amount of due diligence before making an investment. If you're considering investing into a utility token, you should consider the underlying services that give the token value, just like you would with a company. Before investing into a coin or token, it's considered good practice to read through their white paper to familiarize yourself with the project and its applications. Moreover, the Phemex Academy also provides users with informational articles on a wide range of crypto projects, technologies, and investment concepts. The price of a crypto can be significantly more volatile than other assets. Remember that no investment is guaranteed to generate returns, along with the old adage to never invest more than you are willing to lose, and that past performance is not indicative of future results. Currently, despite the recent dip in the market, the total crypto market cap still stands at around $1.3 trillion. Despite numerous boom and bust cycles, the crypto space as a whole is still experiencing massive growth, driven by a more widespread understanding of Bitcoin and innovative projects and applications such as DeFi and NFTs. Analysts have compared the current stage of crypto development with that of the early internet era. The innovative and complex nature of cryptocurrencies means that regulation is slow, ever-changing, and may heavily differ depending on the country.
So that wraps it up for our What is Cryptocurrency introduction video and our first installment of our beginner's course, Introducing Cryptocurrency. In future videos, we'll cover some more specific topics like Bitcoin, Ethereum, DeFi, NFTs, trading, and more. Remember, if you enjoyed this video and you're interested in the following ones and want to keep up with the course, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Also, if you don't mind, give the video a like, comment something, share it. All of that will help out a lot. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.